In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning, everybody. I'm offering this Mass for Sheila White. Please remain seated. Very special welcome to all the children of Holy Name from Key Stage 2 who are joining us for Mass on this Ash Wednesday. It's a real privilege because this is one of the first times since I've been here. I've been here nearly 18 months now, and it's one of the first times that we've been able to gather as a good portion of the school community and the parishioners here. So it's a very special celebration. I'm offering this Mass for Sheila White, and a welcome to everyone who is joining us at home for Mass as well. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may begin with holy fasting this campaign of Christian service, so that as we take up battle against spiritual evils, we may be armed with weapons of self-restraint. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. Amen. Now invite Lola, Samuel and Sophie, who are going to read our first reading and then our song.
A reading from the prophet Joel. The Lord says, "Repent sincerely and return to me, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Let your broken heart show your sorrow. Tearing your clothes is not enough. Come back to the Lord your God. He is kind and full of mercy. He is patient and keeps his promise. He is always ready to give and not punish." The words of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Response. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. Just to make it a bit
loud. Be merciful to me, O God, because of your constant love, because of your great mercy, wipe away my sins. Wash away all my evil and make me clean from my sin. Response.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned.
I recognize my faults. I am always conscious of my sins. I have sinned against you and done what you consider evil. So you are right in judging me. You are justified in condemning me. Response.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Create a pure heart in me, O God, and put a new and loyal spirit in me. Do not banish me from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit away from me. Response.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned.
Give me again the joy that comes from your salvation, and make me willing to obey you. Help me to speak, Lord, and I will praise you. Response.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, "Make sure you do not perform your religious duties in public so that people will see what you do. If you do these things publicly, you will not have any reward from your Father in heaven. So when you give something to a needy person, do not make a big show of it as the hypocrites do in the houses of worship and on the streets. They do it so people will praise them. I assure you, they have already been paid in full. But when you help a needy person, do it in such a way that even your closest friend will not know about it. Then it will be a private matter, and your Father, who sees what you do in private, will reward you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Today marks the beginning of the 40 days of Lent. We have 40 days now to prepare our lives for the new life that we celebrate at Easter. We have 40 days to make the word of Jesus flower in our lives by making a special effort to do what he asks. If we're not careful, even the most precious and special of gifts can wear out and crack. They can become covered with greasy dust, and then we can't see their beauty anymore. The same applies to people. The most beautiful feelings, the most radiant smiles, our friendships and our trust in God can crack and break if we're not careful. With time, dirt covers them up, and finally we don't recognise them anymore. They become like ashes. Then we become incapable of love. We don't see what is good, and so we become like ashes. And now, today, we begin Lent. It is like a sunrise in our lives. The word Lent comes from the Old English word for spring. Lent is the time when God calls us to be new all the time, to be new in the way we love God and others, to be new inside ourselves, to be new and better people. So ask God now to bless these ashes which will be placed on our foreheads. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly ask God our Father that he be pleased to bless with the abundance of his grace these ashes which will be placed on our heads in penitence. O God, who desire not the death of sinners, but their conversion, mercifully hear our prayers, and in your kindness be pleased to bless these ashes, which we intend to receive upon our heads, that we who acknowledge that we are but ashes, and shall return to dust, may through a steadfast observance of Lent, gain pardon of sins and newness of life, after the likeness of your risen Son, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. Invite Mrs. Radford, Mr. Morris, and Mrs. Hughes to please come forward. Try not to say the word Jesus twice. Try not to say the word Jesus twice. Try not to say the word Jesus twice. So I've asked the members of staff from school to help me with the distribution of the ashes this morning, just so that it goes more smoothly. One of the ways that we can show Jesus that we're taking Lent seriously is by doing this mass, please to not talk during the distribution of the ashes. I'm going to put some quiet music on that we'll play. Now please, I know it's a bit funny to have some ashes on your forehead and you want to see what you look like. You'll have the opportunity to do that later, so please, you've been fantastic this morning. So please, whilst the ashes are being distributed, please be quiet. Members of staff, if you can supervise, please, the children coming forward. I'm going to ask Mr. Morris and Mrs. Hughes to go halfway down the church, and then if you can bring them from this end and send them back that way if that's possible. And Mrs. Radford and I will do it up here at the front, and then we'll come over and do this side. Thank you so much for your behaviour. I realise that was a difficult time when we're having the ashes on our foreheads, but I really, really, truly appreciated how prayerful and silent you were during that. Thank you very much. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Please remain seated. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we solemnly offer the annual sacrifice for the beginning of Lent, we ask you, O Lord, that through works of penance and charity, we may turn away from harmful pleasures and cleanse from our sins, may become worthy to celebrate devoutly the passion of your Son, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Malcolm our Bishop, his assistant bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The staff, please, could you show forward, please, the children who have made their first Holy Communion only, please, to simplify Holy Communion. I realise that might be a difficulty, but if you only the children come forward, please, who've made their first Holy Communion. If you, when you're coming forward, please remember to put one hand on top of the other and allow the minister, either Mr. Penketh or myself, to place the host into your hand first before you take it away. Thank you. Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received sustain us, O Lord, that our Lenten fast may be pleasing to you and be for us a healing remedy through Christ our Lord. Amen. Can we show some appreciation for these fantastic children, please? What a great, beautiful way to begin Lent with a lovely Mass celebrated together with the school and the parish coming together. Thank you to all the staff. Thank you to everyone who's come this morning. Thank you. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. Pour out your Spirit, O God, on those who bow before your majesty, and by your mercy may they merit the rewards you promise to those who do penance through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Thank you for joining me for Mass this morning, those of you here in church and those of you at home. May God bless.